Good evening, everyone, and welcome to a very special edition of The Fray, as tonight we begin the first stop, the very first step on the road to Evolution 2014. My name is Derry, and joining us tonight, my only guest. Normally we do a roundtable panel. Tonight it's just me and him. He's coming to you live to bring you the announcement of which games are going to be featured at Evolution 2014. Twitter.com/Mr. Evil Wizard. He's one of the masterminds behind the Evolution Tournament series, and Shoryuken.com. You can follow Evo's news and the tournament itself at Twitter.com/Evo2K. Welcome to the program, Mr. Wizard.
Good evening. What's going on, Derry?
Not much. I'm waiting with everybody else to find out what games are going to be at Evo this year. We were supposed to broadcast on Tuesday, and we ended up getting bodied by weather and travel arrangements, but you're here tonight, and I'm not gonna beat around the bush too much. I'm gonna go ahead and hand it over to you to let you go ahead and kick it off. No further ado, and let these people know what games are gonna be appearing this year.
Yeah, so this year we are at the fabulous LVH Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas. For many of you don't know, that's the old Hilton, which is next to the convention center. Downtown Las Vegas. The cool part about the hotel is it's cheaper than a normal strip hotel, so that you can have cheaper nights. Because let's be honest, like when you're in Vegas, you're only going to be in the room to like sleep, shower, maybe play a few games, but that's it. So it's always a good thing when things are cheaper and there's a monorail that basically takes you from the hotel to the strip for $5, which is a really good deal. So we're pretty happy with the hotel this year. The link for the room rate, I know everyone's been waiting on that. It's going to go on my Twitter in about as soon as this announcement's over, and that way you can book your room and be good to go.
All right, so you guys, again, if you don't follow on Twitter, it's twitter.com/MrEvilWizard. You're going to go ahead and be able to start booking your Evo rooms.
No, it is Evil Mr. Wizard.
Evil, that's what I said.
No, you said Mr. Evil Wizard.
Oh, my bad.
That's all right.
All right. Anyway, you can go ahead and start booking your Evo rooms tonight with the special rate after the announcement.
Yeah, I just put the link up right now on Twitter, so if you wanted to go ahead and get that done, you can go ahead and do that right now.
Awesome. I'm sure people out there have been speculating. I don't know what I have no idea myself. I don't know the order. I'm going to go ahead and let you kick it off with whatever order you please with the reveal on these games.
All right. So this is the start of the new season for Evo and all of our grassroots tournaments that join us. And obviously the first game is one of the two obvious ones that happens at Evo every year. And to no speculation, it's obviously Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. This game has been a huge favorite over the past years. Slight of a sliding action. Grand Finals both years have gone down to the last game of the last set, which is pretty insane. And a lot of memories have been made at Evo with this game, and we look forward to having it back this year.
So this is the fourth appearance for Marvel vs. Capcom 3. It's the going to be the third appearance for Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Like you said, the championships have been one of the highlights of each of the years so far. Last year's Justin Wong run through the bracket was a topic of conversation. We were just talking about that on this show last month. So I'm looking forward to seeing Ultimate Marvel at Evo this year.
Yeah, that was one of the few tournaments that I've never seen anything like that. Like, Justin was on a mission, and him being down 0-2 to Chris G and then deciding, okay, it's go time, and pulling it back from the grave is pretty incredible. And then no short of what he did in the finals versus Flocker as well. He was on the brink and brought it back, which made for a memorable tournament.
All right. Next on the list.
Yeah, this is also the other obvious one, obviously. For people who don't know, Capcom has announced that Ultra Street Fighter 4 will be available in early June 2014. And we are going ahead and we're going to use that for Evo this year, pending it makes it out in June. It's not that big of a change from the current system. It still has focuses. It still has all the stuff. Just a little bit of tweaking with the red focus and the delayed getup and all that. But we feel it's enough time. Remember, this exact scenario happened in 2011 when AE was out, and it came out in June, and it provided for one of the more memorable tournaments at Evo that year, with all the crazy Punko Daigo stuff and Latif running the bracket and all that kind of jazz. So we do think it's enough time. We do know there's 4 or 5 new characters. There's some changes to the game, but we think the veterans will have plenty of time to learn the changes, and I think everyone will be happy.
I know a lot of the veterans are traveling specifically to places that are featuring early builds of the game to get their hands on it. I know I was at SF25, and a lot of players were there talking about how, you know, one of the primary reasons they had come to the event was to try and get as much time with Ultra as possible when they could. So I think that you're probably right in that there will be people there who will be maybe a little underprepared, but for the most part, guys who are going to be taking this tournament seriously, I think will be coming to play at Evo.
Yeah, I mean, definitely people want the advantage, and as far as I know, the game comes out in April in the arcade, so you might end up seeing people fly to Japan just to get that early edge and get the early playing so they can have the edge at Evo, which is pretty insane, but it's all part of the circle of life for Street Fighter, so...
Well, I know there were guys who did that for AE. You mentioned it earlier, 2011. I know of quite a few players, actually, who flew to Japan and spent a couple months there boning up on their arcade edition in the arcade. So we'll see. But those are the two, I think, that are I don't think anybody in their right mind would think that those games are not on the lineup. Now we're moving into territory where nothing is guaranteed. I'll let you go ahead and announce the third game of this list of games that is not really a lock.
Yeah, you're definitely right. Those are the two games that were only a lock this year. There were some people out there who thought other games were locks, but nothing was really locked in for this year other than the proven track records of those two games. But for the third game, for Evolution 2014, it is a returning game. It is it's a game that had a lot of entries last year, and we're happy to see it back. And that game is Injustice. They just had a balance patch, which is pretty crazy, that really, really tied up the roster and make it really tight-knit, and all these top eights across the country I'm seeing now is... just different top 8 people every time because the roster is so close together. So we're glad that it got balanced, and we think a lot of people will be happy with the Injustice tournament this year at Evo.
Does it make it a little bit easier for you to pull the trigger on the decision to include the game now that the game has been balanced and it's not so much, you know, Superman and his cast of colorful characters?
Yeah, that was definitely a deciding factor. If they didn't, if NRS didn't pay attention and left the game the way it was, it probably wouldn't have been back this year. But they're truly dedicated to the fans, and they decided that they want to keep this game going. And they had it out on PS4 now, so people can play it on the new systems. And so I think that was definitely a determining factor, because the old game, it was 2 or 3 characters, and it was everyone doing the same combos over and over, and just wasn't fun to watch. So,
right on. And I know that the Mortal Kombat community is going to be pretty psyched to hear about that. Moving right along, let's talk about the fourth game.
All right, so the fourth game this year is a definitely a fan favorite. Last year, it started off our Sunday run, and we're glad to see it back. And that's King of Fighters 13. We definitely had a great time watching that last year. It was a super memorable tournament for the past 2 years. We think the game is pretty balanced, and it's a really, truly international game. And we just love seeing people fly out, and this is their game that they get hype about. And even had the coveted Sunday morning 10 a.m. slot, and yet the hall was pretty packed, and the stream viewers tuned in super early. So we were really, really excited that this game is back this year.
Justin's run through Marvel last year was probably my favorite Evo moment from 2013, but I have to say, in a very close second, the grand finals for KOF 13 and the grand finals for KOF in 2012 were also amazing. So I am super, super excited to see KOF at EVO in 2014.
Yeah, there's some speculation about, like, the players aren't playing it, only playing it, like, big events. But, I mean, I think it's still got the international appeal to bring the hype back and maybe get some people to play on the road to EVO up this year. So I think it's a great game. It's got a lot of variety, and it's got some flair. So definitely happy to see it back.
All right. And we're moving now into territory, getting towards the three-quarters point with the list. I'll let you go ahead and talk about game number five.
All right, game number five is brand new to EVO this year. We do think it has potential. It's got one of the best systems I've ever seen in terms of rewarding players for mind games and footsies and all that, and that would be Killer Instinct. Killer Instinct is a new game on Xbox One, and we're not worried about the barrier that blocks new players from having to buy a new system and a joystick and all that. Because I think down the road to playing a great game, people will pick it up, and maybe you don't have it, but maybe your friend has it. You can go over there and practice it. But it's like I think it has the potential to be super exciting. I in the beginning, I didn't think it was fun to watch, and then I went down to Super Arcade and I watched Justin play Filthy Rich, and that was some of the most exciting matches I've ever seen in this game. And just like on that kind of a level, I think it could be really exciting. So we're happy to have Killer Instinct on board this year.
It's cool to see a game which has a community of players that have, from what I've seen, been very vocal about their enthusiasm for the game. They're very loyal to the brand so far. A lot of fighting game releases in the past 3 or 4 years, the game comes out, you get at the most maybe 2 months of excitement, and then the game kind of takes a little bit of a dip. KI seems to be moving pretty steadily with a fervent fan base, and so it's going to be a really awesome treat for that group of players to be able to go to EVO 2014 and play their game on the big stage. I'm really excited to see it myself.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it also says something when the netcode is good. And so you don't really have to go out to arcades, because I know some people do live in, like, Nebraska and Idaho, and they just don't have arcades and places to play. So when the netcode is good and you have a decent internet connection, you can actually get some pretty good games in. So I think that's an overall beneficial thing to this game as well. But, I mean, obviously online play doesn't come into factor at EVO because there's no online play. But it's always a great way just to see the whole game and see what people are doing so you can be ready for it in every situation.
All right. And unless I've missed my count here, I think that leaves us with one more game to be announced. I'll let you go ahead and take it away.
Yeah, so the final game. Well, I'm not even going to say that because there's something else. But the next game in EVO is a new game as well. It does fill the... we think the community for this game is getting back into it, and we saw in a very exciting finals for one of its sister games last year. So we're happy to have BlazBlue this year. Now we do know that is on our PS3, and we do have PS3s for people to play, and so we're not worried about that. And as I said, we are not exclusive to the 360 platform if a game fits our criteria for the lineup. And I think it's going to be super exciting. They recently announced that they're going to patch it to make it closer to the arcade version and get rid of some of the BS that was early on. So that's a really good thing. So we should receive some balanced stuff at EVO for that.
This is BlazBlue's first EVO, which is surprising. I mean, if you think about it, the game's been out for a while. And then you hear, you know, the words out loud, this is BlazBlue's first EVO, and it's like, wow, it really is BlazBlue's first EVO. But here it is. I know that every year this game is not announced, there is a cry of disappointment. There's usually some game to appease fans within that community. I know Melty Blood was on the main stage 1 year, but this is the first year that BlazBlue players are going to get a chance to specifically show off in their game. I'm super excited to see it. A lot of my friends are BlazBlue players. I know a lot of BlazBlue players. So I'm really, really excited to see what the arcade patched version of the game can do. So,
yeah, exactly.
All right. Now, before we go further, I'll throw this out at you. I know that, you know, that's the list. That's the games. So there are a few conspicuous absences. One in particular did really well last year. Super Smash Brothers Melee did exceptionally well in attendance and participation last year, and it's not on the list. I was wondering if maybe you could shed a little insight into that.
Sure. Currently, there is a spot in our lineup for Super Smash Brothers Melee. Last year's event was amazing, and what the Smash community has done over the past year is really, really inspirational. Nintendo has some really cool people over there, and we are currently in discussions with them regarding Smash. We will update you as soon as we have more information. And that's pretty much it. So the spot is there. We just need them to make a decision either way, and we'll be good to go.
And so it's still so what you're saying is it's not definitely off the table, and you're still in discussion with Nintendo about it?
Correct. The discussions are ongoing. They're a really great group of guys over there, and they we're definitely looking forward to it if they allow it. But we don't want to say anything further because we don't want to do anything that jeopardizes the event. So we're just going to leave it at that, and we're going to move on.
Right on. Okay, so there's your list of games, listeners. That's Street Fighter 4, Ultra Street Fighter 4, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, King of Fighters 13, Killer Instinct on the Xbox One, and BlazBlue on the PS3. And I actually made a mistake. I said it was BlazBlue's first Evo, but it's actually their second Evo. So we'll see it back this year. We're going to go right into final thoughts on the lineup with Mr. Wizard in a second. I think he has a couple more things he wants to mention to you guys. But at the end of tonight's program, we're going to be doing a Q&A session with him. You guys can ask him your questions about Evo, your thoughts on the games that are going to be featured this year, if you have any questions on how the games get selected, or maybe what games he's looking forward to. Whatever questions you might have about Evo 2014 or Evo in general, you can tweet them to the iPlayWinner Twitter account at twitter.com/iPlayWinner. And then we'll take the best questions and we'll pass them along here live on the air at the end of the program. But I'll pass it along to Mr. Wizard for his final thoughts on the lineup and any other announcements he wants to make.
Yeah, I think the lineup's a good one. I mean, I know a lot of people are worried about Tekken, and I don't think it's the right time. There was a lot of drop-off last year after Evo, and I know it's the 20th anniversary of Tekken this year. So I assume they wouldn't miss the opportunity to bring out a new game. I bounce knowledge of that. But, I mean, it seems to be with the Tekken community, as soon as a new game is launched, they don't play the old one. And we don't want to go back to that scenario where we're playing an old version when a current new version is out in Japan in the arcades or something like that. So that should answer that regards to Tekken. But we think we covered a lot of bases in this lineup. It's got something for everyone. And if you don't have anything there, then you can always play one of the newer games that are in Evo this year.
So there's something for everybody at Evo, hopefully, this year, with the exception of Tekken, which you touched on. I have to admit, personally, I was a little surprised as well, although I have to agree with what you're talking about with my perceptions as far as the attendance on the tournament goes. A little sad to see it not back, but I'm sure, you know, 2015, 2016, Namco and Tekken will be there in some capacity representing.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, this has only been the second year we haven't had Tekken or a 3D game like Soul Calibur. The last time was in 2009 when Tekken 6 had missed the console window by a few months. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure a 3D game will be back next year. Maybe a Tekken 7 or a new version of Soul Calibur. We'll see. But I think the overall consensus about the lineup is it's pretty well. And I think that everyone will be pretty happy.
All right. So before we went on the other night, we had a discussion about some other things surrounding Evo. Anything you want to announce in addition to the game lineup tonight?
All right. So I know everyone's been asking about the road to Evo and how we're going to do it. And in 2012, we kind of went all in and we included 19 events, which was seemed to be too much. People like Justin Wong were traveling across the world like every week, and it was just too much for the players. And in 2013, we scaled it back. There was only 5 U.S. events, and there was a handful of international ones. So we're going to try to do something different this year. We're going to try to do something similar as the NCAA, where everyone just submits results to us, and then we're still working on the details of it, but if it's a higher population tournament, you'll probably get guaranteed seeding at Evo, and if it's under a certain amount, then you'll qualify for potential seeds. But as I said, we're still working on the math and how that's going to work, and we want everyone to be included. So basically, your tournament organizer will have to submit results to us, and when we figure out the system, then we'll go through the seeding when the brackets or when the registration closes, and we'll end up getting them seeded in proper fashion for Evo 2014.
So what you're saying is that instead of having a set series of events that are the official quote-unquote road to Evo events, we're going to be moving into a system that focuses more on results from nearly all the tournaments that are played, with special preference being played towards, you know, larger slack quote-unquote major tournaments.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, it's definitely a new system for us. I'm going to try to tweak it so that everyone can get a favorable something from it. And we want to include everyone. We don't want to not include people who generally throw grid tournaments, but there was no room for it. So we think that this system will handle all that problems. And going forward, I think everyone will be happy. But as I said, we still have to work on the math and how everything's going to work. So stay tuned for that.
That's really cool. I think that last year I saw some conversation about players, you know, I want to go to this Road to Evo event, but there's a tournament, you know, here that I'm interested in, but it's not necessarily a Road to Evo event, and I only have X amount of money, you know, and so it's really cool to hear you guys talking about just, you know, taking results from the community at large. You know, people can go to the tournaments that they support or are local to them or that they enjoy, and then if they do well, you know, they can affect their Evo standing going into the tournament this year.
Right, exactly. You don't have to end up traveling across country just to qualify for Evo. If there's a big tournament in your neighborhood and it's got a big turnout, you can definitely earn your seeding points that way instead of flying across the country 9 times to try to qualify. So we're trying to make it a little more player-friendly, and I think it will work out well.
All right. Any other side announcements you'd like to make tonight?
All right. So one of the bigger things that is happening this year is it's actually the 20th anniversary of Super Turbo, which is a lot of people's favorite game. It's got the old school, no gimmicky feel. It's just straight up raw fighting, and it's like it's in your face. It's got footsies. It's got mind games. It's got everything you need that a lot of people love. And every year, Bob Painter and his staff does a great job running the Tournament of Legends tournament. And so that will be back this year. But we have a surprise. Their team and the Evo team have been working together to get something special for the 20th anniversary of Evo. And this year, we are happy to announce that Evo will be a location for the first ever X-Mania US. So it's going to be pretty crazy that for the 20th anniversary, we got the tournament or the Tournament Legends, and now on top of that, we got X-Mania US. So that's going to be really cool. We hope a lot of people come out for that. There's going to be more information coming that down the pipe later on, but we just want to announce that this is happening this year, and it's going to be super cool.
So for players at home who are maybe not as familiar with X-Mania, why don't you tell everybody listening a little bit about X-Mania?
So X-Mania is basically the national tournament for Japan for Super Turbo. and it's been going on for some time now. And because Japan is considered the cornerstone of Super Turbo play, I mean, they still have a lot of specialty players over there that only play Super Turbo. They basically focus in Japan. It's basically like their Super Turbo Evo. It's like the best of the best come to play. It's a 3-on-3 single elimination tournament, and that will be the same over here. So you basically have to have a team of three to compete in the event. And it's definitely got super high quality play. If you go Google some videos, you'll see what people are doing in Super Turbo now, and it looks phenomenal. I mean, with the inclusion of like new tech that's being found 16, 17 years later, the game has got a whole new resurgence, and it's going to be super awesome. So we're happy to have X-Mini on board for this Evo this year.
It's a pretty huge cross promotion. We got the Destination Championship tournament for the American fighting game community and the biggest Japanese Cornerstone Super Turbo tournament coming together here in America on American soil. I'm excited to see what Japanese players make the flight. I know that, you know, you talked about Japanese specialists who only play ST or play it as their main game. And we don't really see those guys coming over here for Evo. This might be the year they show up, and I'm really excited to see who's going to come over.
Yeah, exactly. I know Bob Painter and his staff are working on some stuff about getting some of the people who don't travel very often that are like really the specialists to come over this year. So if they can make that happen, that would be really memorable, and I think it would be a great tournament. So look forward to seeing what's coming down the pipe, and now that the news has been released, we look forward to more information coming about that in the future.
All right, moving along, we're going to be hitting our Q&A session fairly soon. You can still tweet your questions to twitter.com/iPlayWinner. I know that Chris is probably up to his neck in questions right now, filtering out the good from the bad. But anything else you wanted to announce before then, Wiz?
No, I think we're good. We've covered the hotel. We've covered the lineup. We've covered the road to Evo. And we've covered the Super Turbo stuff. So I think that's a good chunk of information for now. Obviously, we have more announcements coming down the pipe, but we'll save those for a later date.
Right on. All right. So for those of you guys that are just tuning in, you might have missed it again. This year's Evolution 2014 video game lineup is going to be Ultra Street Fighter 4, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, King of Fighters 13, Killer Instinct, Injustice, and Blaze Blue. All right. And at this point, we're going to transition over. We're going to be answering your questions directly. You guys have been submitting questions since Monday. We originally were going to broadcast on Tuesday, but due to unforeseen difficulties, we had to postpone until today. So we've been collecting questions all week. We're collecting questions tonight. There's still time for you to submit your questions, and we'll see what Wiz can answer for you. First question, it's from Drew Red Mage on Twitter, and his question is, what do you feel people misunderstand the most about the process of the games that you pick for Evo?
I think the easiest misconception is that you could buy your way into Evo, and I know people are not going to believe me when I say that, but it's kind of impossible. We see the potential in games coming down the pipe, and we make an educated decision guess. And it's something people won't believe unless you come in and see the inner circle of Evo, but it's really like it doesn't happen. So, I mean, it's just one of those things that it's always going to haunt us, or are people going to talk about it, and we don't really get into it, but I mean, it's the way it is, and we're always about the players before the companies, and the decisions we have made in the past obviously prove that. So it's a matter of whether you believe me or not, and I'm telling you it's the truth. But I mean, you're gonna believe what you believe anyway. So there's that.
Robert at @ARJEIDI wants to know, can Mr. Wizard talk about the Evo streams at all? How many official streams are there? Will there be a subscription cost? Is there anything he can say?
I think we like the current model of how it is. We did three streams last year. I don't see that being out of the question. I know a lot of people raised concern about we weren't streaming all of the games. We were streaming some of the games, but the community stepped up and they streamed the rest of the game so that if you wanted to watch your game, you could. That being said, we're all in one ballroom this year. Last year it was split. So we'll definitely try to make time for every game on the roster. And we know the community members will step up and stream if we don't have time to stream pools or semifinals or whatever. But we liked the three streams last year, and if it permits, we'll do it again. Same for the subscription model. We think we like how that works. It's cheap enough to where you can support gamers going to college or whatever we're going to use it for this year, but it all goes to charity. So you get some cool icons that no one else can get for the year, and then you support charity and you get the streams in high def, and we think that's a good combination. So definitely we'll look forward to bringing that back this year in the same capacity that it was last year.
Follow-up question for Robert. Mr. Wizard, after the size of that... There we go. Robert wants to know, Mr. Wizard, after the size, and this is going into something that you were just talking about, Mr. Wizard, after the size of last year's Evo's double ballroom filling crowd, do you really feel that we can all fit into the Las Vegas?
So the Las Vegas Hilton ballroom is 70,000 square feet. It can seat 10,000 people. We definitely think that we can seat you without having to go to an overflow room. But who knows? Because our attendance has like gone up about 25-50% every year that we've done an event. So who knows what's going to happen? There's obviously enough space so we don't have to shuffle you to a secondary room, and we don't want to. But the option is there if we need to. We don't like having separate rooms for the finals. We think it kind of detracts from the event, but we had to do what we had to do, and we moved on from it. That being said, if we ever come down to a situation where we don't have enough room and we need to do two ballrooms again, then we'll do it. But that would just rely on you if you want to be in the main ballroom and it's really important to you. I suggest buying your tickets early instead of trying to wait to the last minute to buy them. But yeah, so long story short, yes, we will all try to be in one ballroom this year, and I think we won't have a problem with it this year.
Friend of iPlay winner Esteban at the Besteban wants to know, will exhibitions return to Evo? There were some scheduled for last year, but they were canceled due to time. How about combo videos?
So exhibitions, it seems that when they're announced, they generate a pretty good amount of hype, and everyone's looking forward to it. And last year it was a Street Fighter Country Challenge. What happens is, because these events have to be scheduled on Friday or Saturday, the players might end up playing on Sunday, and they don't want to end up playing each other. So they end up backing out, and that kind of detracts from the event, and then we end up canceling it because people are not there, or they're out drinking, or they want to get some sleep, or whatever the reason is. So we're always high hopes for exhibitions, but in the end, Evo is completely fine with just doing the normal tournament. We think there's enough hype there to just do the tournament and not have exhibitions. But we're always looking for fun stuff, and if it makes sense, we'll make it fit into our schedule. But I wouldn't like look forward to stuff like that, because running Evo is pretty big as it is. So to add it, pile on anything extra is a pain. To the second part of that question, we always like to have combo videos and stuff, but that relies on players to make the combo videos. Madge did making a video for us last year, but he couldn't get it done in time, and so there was no video from him. But we had a cool video from the King of Fighters crew that made it last year. So I'm always hopeful that we can get two or three cool combo videos in. It's one of the things that we used to do back in the day with the grassroots stuff, and we like to bring that tradition forward. So I'm hopeful that we'll get two or three videos this year to show.
All right. Hentai Logic, appropriately enough, wants to know, what happened to the waifu pillow the anime community gave you last year at Evo?
I am still mad at Tom Cannon for that because he straight up lied to me. Because I asked him, is this about the pillow? And he said, no, it's not. And then I got bombarded with that. I don't have it. It was on the stage last I saw. I think one of the anime community members grabbed it and took it home. I was obviously not going to take it home with me. It was more of a joke reference than something I actually wanted. So if someone has it, someone's sleeping with it at night, and more power to them.
Oh, man, that's going to haunt my dreams. Dave at Dragon underscore 316 underscore CA wants to know, what's one or more classic game or games that you wish you could bring back to the EO lineup, and why?
God, it's been so long. I liked the era of Marvel 2 when it wasn't the Runaway Storm. I love the era of when Yipes came in and it was Magneto and Psylocke and them, and it was basically doing mix-up and stuff like that. So I definitely would like to bring back Marvel 2, but, I mean, the systems that it's played on, Dreamcast and PlayStation, aren't really great for tournament play, but, I mean, it's always hype to watch now. And I went to Super Arcade for the last Marvel 2 tournament, and it was pretty fun to watch. Other than that, I mean, obviously, Super Turbo has got a great place in my heart. Other games have come and gone. Nothing really sticks out in terms of, like, fun stuff that I miss that was in Evo. But there's always games that have resurgence that we could always look at bringing back if it makes sense to us. But I would definitely say Marvel 2 at this point.
Alexander at Canadian Pyro wants to know, will Kokonoe be banned in Blaze Blue?
Luckily, we don't have to make that decision until the patch comes out. But in the current state, she probably would have been banned. It's one of those things where if you leave the door open and you let players learn banned stuff, then they'll just abuse it to hell and back. And then it doesn't make for a memorable tournament for the players. But we're lucky enough where the patch is coming down the pipe, I think in May or April or something like that. So I'm sure they'll take care of it and balance the game, and I think we'll be good to go.
At Lord Walkman wants to know, we talked about Super Turbo, but are there going to be any official side tournaments again?
We don't know. It's too early to tell at this point. We're just basically getting started on planning the event for this year, and as I said before, if it makes sense and we can do it, we'll do it. But if it doesn't make sense, we already have a big enough job running Evo. We don't need to add pile on to other stuff that might not do well or it might do well. So we don't want to limit ourselves, but it's always a big task to take on an extra event. And we really don't want to do that without being super rewarding for our players and our fan base. So we'll keep a lookout, but it's not likely at the moment.
And then Walkman, and also, hi, I'm Nasty at DJ Skrull. Want to know, will we be seeing any panels again this year at Evo?
Yes, panels will be back. We think we found a hit with those. It gives a chance for the developers to talk to the hardcorest of the hardcore people who love their game and actually are influencers to the mass public. We think we've been really lucky that the publishers have agreed to do a panel and to talk to their fans, and a lot of good stuff's come from the panels. So it's definitely a fan favorite. We've loved it the past 3 years that we've done it. We're definitely going to bring it back this year, and hopefully we'll have some exciting panels for our members to visit while they're at Evo.
Perfect Legend at Perfect Legend wants to know, are you going to be accepting every tournament's results for this NCAA type format? Many tournaments are trying to call themselves majors.
That is a very good question. I think it only applies to the games that are in Evo. Like if you were to play Cross Tekken or if you're playing Tekken, it doesn't really help us out because it's for seeding purposes. I mean, I can look into it more, but at this point, it doesn't make sense for us to collect data on non-Evo games because if someone else can basically collect all the data for us on those games and maybe do a ranking system, but it doesn't make sense for us to collect it because the data is lost when it's not in Evo.
An undisclosed viewer wants to know if you are FGCNN.
I am not, and I'm currently looking for who is that. I actually looked up the Who Is data earlier, and it is from SoCal. Or they have a good IP blocker or tracer or something like that. But yeah, the Who Is data from that site points to SoCal. It seems to know a lot of people in SoCal because the stories reference a lot of like stuff that happens. But it seems to be a person who's in tune with the community and knows a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff. So I know there's people looking to advertise on that site like Neo. So it's pretty crazy. But I do find some of the humor on that site to be incredibly funny. But there's some posts on that site which are incredibly bad. And I hope they can clean up their act and make it more funny than bad.
Harrison SBA wants to know, will Marvel be 3 out of 5 for the entire tournament? Will Ultra Street Fighter 4 be 3 out of 5 for top 8 again?
So last year, yes, we had a little bit of an issue with Marvel being 2 out of 3 for ADM pools, and then we ended up changing it, and that pissed a lot of people off. But we're very clear that we can see that Marvel does run in the time frame that we're looking to, which is a 2-hour pool period. So we see no problem with it running 3 out of 5, pending Evo doesn't get double the number of entrants for next year or this year. Obviously, at that point, there's a threshold when if you hit that threshold, then it's obviously going to have to be 2 out of 3 for pools. As far as games in the top 8 getting 3 out of 5, it's a case-by-case basis. We have to see how Ultra plays. It seems to me at this point Ultra's playing a little bit slower than its counterpart, AE, and that could always raise a concern with our time issues. We don't like to finish late on Sunday. We like to try to get out of there 7 or 8 o'clock if we can. That being said, we thought the 3 out of 5 was cool for AE. If we didn't go 3 out of 5, we wouldn't have had the Hakan moment where Infiltration came back with Hakan. And we wouldn't have had so many air fireballs by Akuma. But, so we'll definitely look at it down the road. There's no promises at this point. We thought it was good, but we'll definitely look at it for further evaluation.
All right. This is a good question. Carlos at CTCDA6V would like to know, how can he apply to be an international seed pit stop and the invitation visa letter?
Yeah, okay, so as I mentioned earlier about the road to Evo, we're just basically taking, we'll probably put out a road to Evo logo that you can use at your events and you can promote it as such. And then you just report the results to us. There's no like real like acceptance or whatever. If you feel that you want to, if your players are excited about going to Evo, I mean, obviously the points don't matter if none of these people are going to Evo. So there has to be some kind of player base that has the desire to travel to Evo, otherwise the points make no sense. So anyone who has a group of people in an international country that has people that want to go to Evo is definitely open to using the Road to Evo logo and putting it up and advertising it as such and reporting the results to us, and we'll be happy to take that. The second part, I forgot what the second part of the question was. It was about...
And the invitation visa letter.
Yes, a lot of people need an invitation letter to get to Evo because their governments are not sure why they're leaving the country. If you just email me at MrWizard@Shuriken.com, or if you just contact me on Twitter, I'll be happy to get that letter out to you. We usually just send them a PDF copy of the letter, and if their government requires me to mail it to the embassy, then we have to charge you the cost associated with mailing it to the embassy. But for most governments, they accept the PDF of the letter, and that should be fine when you're submitting it. But when you email me, I need your full legal name, your national ID number, and your passport number, and then I can get a letter out to you.
All right. Last few questions here. I got a couple of people wanting to know if you guys are planning on doing anything special for the 10-year anniversary of the Daigo Perry.
I literally hadn't thought about it. I know Glenn Cravens, who used to run GYT, he's writing a book, and he's interviewed a bunch of people who were there and who actually participated in it. And the thoughts and feedbacks of that stuff. But yeah, I totally forgot about that. We can definitely look at doing something for this year because I forgot that it was 2004. But yeah, thanks for putting that on our minds, and we'll definitely look for that in the future. Maybe we'll do something cool.
Awesome. KOCast at KOCastSB would like to know, will the Las Vegas hotel have enough room for Bring Your Old Console this year?
Yes. So that's one of my pet peeves. So there's two things I needed, as a group, two things that Evo needs to fix that we saw big problems with last year. One was the BYOC. We know it's just getting dominated by people who want to run tournaments, and we understand that. And we have a lot more space this year. So, yes, the BYOC will be back in action. It will be thriving with stations to play your favorite games. We'll provide a great deal of the consoles, so you won't even have to bring a console or a monitor. Just bring your sticks. And then we'll have a dedicated area for tournament players who want to play side tournaments and stuff like that. The other thing that we need to fix, and I think we have a good grasp on what we need to fix for this year, was the registration. A lot of people didn't heed our warning to come down early and pick up their passes, and they tried to show up at 7 o'clock on Friday morning, which caused an incredibly long line, which actually ran outside of the Bally's Hotel into the parking lot, and it was creating quite a big fire hazard. So we've created some stuff that will make that run faster. We incorporated some barcode technology, which hopefully will speed the line through and we'll get you a badge faster than we ever have. But that being said, it's always good to register early, whether if you're in the hotel. And we'll look at opening the registration hours to a little bit later. So if you get there later on Thursday night, we might be able to register you till 11, 11:30 or something like that. But it's always a good idea to pick up your pass and then just go back to the hotel room or go to dinner or whatever. That way you don't have to worry about that kind of stuff come Friday morning. So it's definitely a player needs to know basis kind of thing.
So that's really cool. I took a peek over at Twitter earlier while you were addressing a topic. And one of the cool things I like about the FGC is the DIY attitude a lot of players have. And after we announced the list of games, I already saw several people saying, hey, if anybody wants to play this game, if anybody wants to play that game, I'm bringing a setup. Let's get a tournament going. So it's really cool to hear you talking about, you know, making sure that everybody has space to do what they want, both the players who just want to get some sets in casually and the players who want to do their own little side tournaments with their friends.
Yeah, exactly. Like, we didn't realize a lot of people. I spoke with a great deal about feedback for last year, and I didn't realize the number of people who actually come out and just want to play people, not in the tournament setting. They just want to have some friendly casuals, and that kind of struck a chord with me of, like, why did we... I mean, it wasn't on purpose that we were trying to get rid of the BYOC, but it just seemed like it got cut down because of the space concerns. But yeah, I definitely want to bring that back in grand fashion to have stations for people to do what they want. And we know it's like a once-a-year gathering for all the friends and players of the community. So we definitely want to have the space for them to do that. And I think we'll definitely fix it for this year. So community has already started to plan, hey, we're going to do a side tournament, blah, blah, blah. Let's get people involved.
And this next question involves an Evo favorite. Beth at Prototype Axel would like to know if there's any chance this year for a Bang the Machine screening.
Yeah, it's always a possibility. We usually generally like to do it back to back years because it would turn the hype down. But we literally thought everyone had seen the movie, and it just seems that there's droves and droves of people every year who hadn't seen the movie and are looking for a place to see it. And when we showed it in SoCal, it was pretty hype, and people came out to watch it at Super Arcade. I mean, Peter Kang, who owns the movie, has been really good about letting us show it whenever we want to. And if it makes sense, we'll definitely show it again. But yeah, I think it's been a few years since we've shown it. It was either 2011 or 2012 that we last shown it. And we'll definitely... try to show it again this year. We think it's even though I've seen it like a billion times and I don't really stick around to watch it anymore, but we know there's people out there that want to see it, and maybe this is their first time to Evo and they would love to see it, so We'll try to make it happen. No promises, but we'll try to make it happen.
All right. And then final question of the night, Jose at the Hound 2, at the underscore Hound 2, wants to know if there's going to be a chance for another donation drive for this year's Evo. Like last year, it's always good to help out a good cause.
You're right. Yeah, we thought the donation drive last year was incredible. Going into the donation drive last year, we thought maybe we'll get 25,000, and the community straight up blew us away with their competition of over $200,000. We didn't think there was a field for it this year, because if it comes down to a game that's just going to have a landslide, then no one's going to care about it. And it seemed the last year we had several games that could have made it. There was My Little Pony before all the drama happened. There was Skullgirls. There was Smash. There was Super Turbo. There was generally a large number of games that could have won that poll. This year, some of those games might be in Evo. They might not. And it just seems like it wasn't the right time to do it, because there was plenty of new games out on the horizon that we had included in our lineup. And that kind of stuff only comes down to when we're either short on games or we really don't know what the community wants. And we think we nailed it this year, but I mean, it's always a great thing when we can raise money for charity. And we'll definitely look at doing it something again in the future, but for this year, it's not going to happen.
All right, that's the final question for tonight's Q&A. Any final closing thoughts from you, Wiz, tonight?
I just look forward to having you guys all come out again. It's a great event. I know this is the concerns about how we do stuff, but we're always looking out for the player, and whether you believe it or not, we'll always fight for you and give you the best possible stuff that we have to offer. So if we've done you wrong in the past, I truly apologize. We have a fun hype event every year, and it's a great way to see all your friends and see everyone again, because maybe you can't get out to all these other events and you maybe have one vacation for the year, and this might be it for you. So we're definitely always striving to make the event better. I'm always open for feedback. You can hit me up on Twitter at EvilMrWizard, or you can send me an email at MrWizard@Shuriken.com. I would love to discuss anything you want to discuss to make the event better, because that's what we're about. So we look forward to seeing each and every one of you at Evo this year.
Right on. And that's the games list, guys. In case you missed it again for the last time, the games at this year's Evolution 2014 tournament, coming to you live from the Las Vegas Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada, are going to be Ultra Street Fighter 4, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, Killer Instinct, Injustice, KOF 13, and Blaze Blue. Would like to thank Mr. Wizard for taking the time. I know that it's been a struggle for him to be able to get things nailed down logistically. On Tuesday, we were supposed to broadcast, but he wasn't able to make it due to unforeseen circumstances. But we appreciate his time tonight coming on and telling you guys about the games that are going to be featured on this year's Road to Evo. And I just want to say, on a personal note, I'm very excited to see you guys enthusiastic. I'm looking at Twitter and people are already talking about Blaze Blue matchups and how there's no players in Japan that play certain characters. They're coming to America. It's going to be a blow up, and people are excited about Super Turbo. I saw, you know, people posting GIFs on NeoGAFs about Super Turbo. So, super excited, infectious enthusiasm from the community. Looking forward to seeing what you guys are going to do in the brand new format for the Road to Evo tournament series, moving into the Evo tournament this year. Thank you to Chris Egli, our producer, for filtering out your guys' questions tonight and giving us the best ones for the on-air question and answer segment. You can always catch the fray live at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time here on twitch.tv/iPlayWinner and youtube.com/iPlayWinner every Thursday. Well, not every Thursday, but most Thursdays. And then, thanks to the Canons for partnering up with Wiz and getting this information out to you guys. Thanks to everybody that's involved in the Evo tournament series. You guys can get more information about Evo through the official tournament stop and news source at shoryuken.com and their Twitter account at twitter.com/Evo2K. And that's going to do it for this week. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. Make sure that you tune in next week. I can't do Magnus's voice. So I'm not even going to attempt it. Well, maybe. Yo, Frey.